Good morning, children. Sai Ram. Children, in the previous presentation, we have started with the topic hybridization and we have reached up to the topic types of hybridization. We have discussed one example. I'm revising it again today, and after that, we'll start with the types of hybridization. Children, as I've told you, hybridization is the process of mixing of atomic orbitals which are having slightly different energy. Like for example, there is a very less energy difference between 2s and 2p orbital. So what happens in case of hybridization? 2s and 2p orbitals can hybridize together and they form a new set of orbital is formed, which is having equivalent energy and shape. So you must have understood now the process. In the process of hybridization, the remixing of atomic orbitals takes place, and only those atomic orbitals remix which have equivalent energy, almost equivalent energy. So a redistribution of energy takes place between them and result in the formation of a new set of orbital having equivalent energy and shape. Now coming to the salient features of hybridization. Now see, the number of hybrid orbitals formed are always equal to the number of atomic orbitals that get combined. As I've told you in the previous example, when 2s and 2p orbitals combine, then 4 orbitals are actually combining. One is 2s and 3 from the 2p orbitals. So 4 new hybrid orbitals will be formed. Second is, the hybridized orbitals are always equivalent in energy and shape. That means the new set of orbital that is formed will have equivalent energy and shape. The third point is, the hybrid orbitals are more effective in forming stable bonds than the pure atomic orbitals. That means when hybridization takes place, then the resultant bond that is formed is more stable compared to the pure atomic orbital. The fourth point is, these hybrid orbitals are directed in the space in preferred directions to have minimum repulsion between the electron pair. So they provide a particular geometry to the molecule. Now we have to start with the types of hybridization today. Children, hybridization depends upon the hybrid orbitals which are hybridizing. So it can be of many types. It can be sp hybridization, it can be sp2 hybridization, it can be sp3 hybridization. What do you think? Sp4 is possible? No, sp4 is not there. It can then be sp3d, or it can be sp3d2, or it can also be dsp2, or many other types of hybridization are possible. So today we'll be discussing different types of hybridization which are there in your syllabus. Now you have to remember, when I'm talking about sp hybridization, that means one s orbital is involved in hybridization and one p orbital is involved. When I'm talking about sp2 hybridization, that means s orbital involved is only one, whereas the p orbitals involved are two. When I'm talking about sp3 hybridization, that means there is one s orbital and three p orbitals involved. When I'm talking about sp3d, that means one s orbital, 3p orbital and 1d orbital is involved. These are the outer orbital complex. That means the d orbital that we have involved in the process of hybridization is from the outside. sp3d2 means one s orbital, 3p orbital and 2d orbital. dsp2 means the inner d orbital. Like for example, the s orbital is from 4s, then d orbital will be from 3d, that is inner d orbital. dsp2, 1d orbital, 1s orbital and 2p orbitals are involved. So children, first of all, I'm starting with the sp type of hybridization. Now, as I have already told you, in sp type of hybridization, one s orbital is involved and one p orbital is involved. Now, children, an example of a molecule showing sp hybridization is BeCl2. Now, in BeCl2, the central atom is always that atom which is only one. Others are which are surrounding that atom. Now, the central atom is beryllium. The atomic number for beryllium is 4, and the configuration will be sp2 1s2 2s2 is the electronic configuration for this atom. Now, children, if we draw the orbitals, then it will be in the ground state. The outermost orbital is 2s. We'll write only 2s. In the ground state, there are 2 electrons in the 2s orbital. You all know p orbital is also present, but there is no electron there in the p orbital. So, 2 electrons in 2s orbital, but p orbital is empty. Now, what happens? You all know that in the compound BeCl2, one beryllium is surrounded by 2 chlorine. That means it needs to have 2 unpaired electrons. For forming a bond, unpaired electrons are required. So, what happens? In the excited state, the s orbital and p orbital, as they are having very less energy difference, they undergo hybridization and form a new set of orbital, that is sp orbital. This orbital is called sp orbital, and what will happen? One electron that was previously present in the s orbital will jump to the p orbital. So, one electron in s orbital, one electron in p orbital. Now, what will happen in the formation of BeCl2? This s orbital will overlap with orbital of chlorine, and this p orbital will also overlap with the another orbital of another chlorine. So, such hybridization is called sp hybridization. Now, when we'll discuss about the Vespers theory, then we'll discuss about the shapes of orbitals also. Right now, you just have to remember that whenever the hybridization is sp hybridization, the geometry is linear. Like, beryllium will be present in the center, one chlorine on this side, and the other chlorine will be present on this side, and the bond angle between the two will be equal to 180 degrees. So, the geometry is linear. Now, coming to the second type of hybridization. The second type of hybridization is sp2 hybridization. That means one s orbital is involved and two p orbitals are involved. Now, in this sp2 hybridization, I'll take example of a molecule BeCl3. Now, in this BeCl3 molecule, the central atom is boron, which is surrounded by 3 chlorine atoms. Now, for boron, the atomic number is 5, and the configuration, the electronic configuration will be equal to 1s2, 2s2, 2p1. So, the outermost shell is second shell. In the ground state, in the second shell, in the 2s orbital, 2 electrons are present, and in 2p orbital, only 1 electron is present. But in the compound, you all can see beryllium has to form a bond with 3 chlorine atoms. To form 3 bonds, it need to have 3 unpaired electrons. That means this electron needs to be transferred to this empty orbital. But how it will transfer? Only when hybridization takes place, because there's an energy difference between this orbital and this orbital. So, what will happen? The s orbital will hybridize with the p orbital and will form a new set of orbital that will be called sp 2 orbital. So what will happen now? The electron that was present here will jump to the p orbital. Now 3 unpaired electrons are there. As 3 unpaired electrons are there, so 3 bonds will be formed with these 3 chlorine atoms. And you have to remember that whenever hybridization is sp2, the geometry will be trigonal planar. It will be trigonal planar. Now about this geometry we'll discuss again when we'll discuss the Weber's theory. Now see children, the next type of hybridization is sp3 type of hybridization. Now what happens in sp3 hybridization? 1 s orbital and 3 p orbitals are involved. Now an example of a molecule that undergoes sp3 hybridization is CH4. What is CH4? Methane molecule. Methane molecule, carbon is the central atom. For carbon, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. That is 2, 4, 6. 6 is the atomic number for carbon and the configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p2. Now, what happens for this? The outermost shell is the second shell. So, in the second shell, if we write the configuration in the ground state, it will be 2 electrons are present in 2s orbital and 2 electrons are present in 2p orbital. But the electrons that are present in p orbital are already unpaired, whereas the electrons which are present in the s orbital, they are paired. So, in order to form CH4, this carbon needs to form 4 bonds with 4 different hydrogen atoms. For this, the s orbital and p orbital will undergo hybridization and a new set of orbital having equivalent energy and shape will be formed, and one electron from here will jump to here and 2 electrons are already present here. So the hybridization now becomes sp3. Now you have to remember, whenever the hybridization is sp3, the shape of the molecule will always be this bond above the plane and these 3 bonds present below the plane. They are present in the form of a tetrahedron like this. Again, I'll draw it for you. It will be C, one above the plane. This is the plane. This is the central plane. And 3 bonds above the plane forming a tetrahedron. So, this molecule, this geometry is tetrahedral. T-E-T-R-A, tetrahedral, H-E-D-R-A-L, tetrahedral. Now children, coming to the next type of hybridization, the next type of hybridization that we'll be discussing is sp3d. Now an example of a molecule showing sp3d type of hybridization is PCl5. Now in PCl5, the central atom is obviously phosphorus. For phosphorus, the electronic configuration is 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p3. So, the outermost shell configuration is 3s2, 3p3. Now, on the basis of that, in the ground state, in 3s, 3p. 3s is having 2 electrons and 3p orbitals are having 3 electrons and all the 3 electrons are unpaired electrons. Now, what will happen? This electron needs, the electron that is present in the s orbital needs to be needs to become unpaired. Now how will it will become unpaired? Only when it will jump to higher orbital. But in higher orbital you can already see unpaired electrons are present. So the next higher orbital that will be taking will be the d orbital. So what will happen in the excited state? S orbital, 3 p orbitals and 1 d orbital will hybridize and form a new set of orbital that will be sp3d. sp3d means 1 electron, 2 electron, 3 electron, 4 electron and 5 electrons. Now these 5 electrons will overlap with the orbitals of chlorine containing the unpaired electron and will form bond. Now you have to remember, whenever the hybridization state is sp3d, then the geometry of the molecule will be, for the central atom will be present at the center, 3 atoms will be present on the same plane like this. Now these 3 atoms are present on the same plane, these are of chlorine, Cl, 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 one above the plane, one below the plane. So if we see, these 3 are present on same plane, so they are forming a pyramid, and down also they are forming a pyramid. So the shape of the molecule is trigonal by pyramidal. Bipyramidal means 2 pyramids are there and the base of the pyramid is triangle. So the shape of the molecule is trigonal bipyramidal. Now the next type of hybridization that we have to discuss is sp3d2. Now an example of a molecule which is showing sp3d2 type of hybridization is SF6. In SF6 molecule, the central atom is sulfur. The configuration for sulfur is 1s2, 2s2, 16 is the atomic number. So 1s2, 2s2, 2p6, 3s2, 3p6.